Here we have a saw blade for cutting thread slots, and here is a very tiny router bits for routing thread slots. In the past, I used to do it like this. With my saw blade, I cut all the slots in the fretboard, like this. What you get is you have to cut a little too deep, actually, because after you cut the slots and after you glue the fingerboard, then you're going to make a radius in the fingerboard, and so you lose a bit of wood here, and you want the tang of the fret to still have enough room to fit in there. So that's why you make an oversized fret slot, so that afterwards, after you make the radius in the fingerboard, you will not get into trouble. This is a very common method. I used to do it for many years, and many other guitar factories do that. But there's a problem with this, and the problem is you lose a lot of the strength of the wood. As you can imagine, all those cuts in the wood, it takes all the strength out of it. It's very flexible now, it's no longer rigid. So we came up with another idea, and that was this, that we route the fret slots. And the advantage is, when we route it, we can stop 2 millimeters before the edge of the fingerboard. The advantage is that we have an edge that gives it a little more strength. And the advantage is we can hide the tang of the fret, so that we don't have the problem of fret sticking out after a couple of seasons. But still, this was not the best solution. Now we have come up with an even better solution, but I cannot show you it on a fingerboard, because nowadays we do different. What we do is we glue the wood on the neck, then we make the radius, and then we make the fret slots. So I cannot show you a separate fingerboard, because it would have been glued on the neck already, and then I cannot demonstrate that it's a lot more stiff. But as you can see, this is very flexible, and this is a lot stiffer already. Let me show you on my drawing what I mean by our even better method. So this is the traditional way of cutting fret slots. So you have a fingerboard, you cut the slot, afterwards you send the radius in it. So here in the slot you get this, and you have this little space left, but you need it for the tang of the fret. But as you can imagine, here is a lot of space under the fret, where there's wood is cut away, and there's nothing there anymore. So our solution now is we glue the fretboard on the neck, then we make the radius, and then we route the fret slots, and we route them also curved in the radius. So the depth that we route is exactly the depth of the tang of the fret. We stop before the edge, so that you have maximum maximum strength of the wood, maximum stiffness, rigidity. So you keep the best specs of the wood that you choose, and you only make as tiny as possible a slot, just enough for the fret to sit in there. And I think that's the best way to do a fret.